Ball on News Radio 99. Brought to you in part by the Toyota dealers of Hawaii. Budweiser, the king of beers. For all you do, this Bud's for you. By Continental Airlines, the largest international airline serving Hawaii. Rainbow Football also brought to you by Bank of Hawaii, Hawaii's bank. Long's Drugs and Kodak. You always get the very best at Long's. The law offices of John Shannon in Honolulu and on Kauai. By Servco Office Systems, your authorized RICO dealer. By the new Suzuki Swift, the first automobile from Suzuki sold in Hawaii. Marion's Catering, make it an occasion and call Marion's for your next party or other function. And by Oceanic Cablevision, be watching for all the OIA football action on Oceanic Cable 17.
Just a few minutes away from the opening kickoff, the Rainbows against BYU. The Rainbows, for them, this is their big night. We've mentioned it. We mentioned it last week, in fact, the possibility of bowl games and all that, really stretching the imagination at this point. So this is the night. As the Rainbows, their captains start to make the walk out to midfield, as do the BYU captains for the opening coin toss. Look back on the series. BYU, in particular, in recent years, has come into town and barely escaped with victories. And talking with Chuck Cotler, the receiver who is now a radio announcer for the Cougars, he said, you know, that kind of thing really builds confidence, that kind of domination. You figure in a close game, down at the end, something's going to happen and you're going to win. The Rainbows have to overcome that.
Yeah, and if you understand the attitude of the opponent, their attitude is, if it's close, we're going to pull it out. And so what the Rainbows have to do, I feel, if a goal they have to make, they have to put points on the board early, take advantage of opportunities given to them. If the defense can cause some turnovers, the offense has to come in and punch it in. We can't be settling for Jason Elam field goals one after another, although they would be good, but you have to turn some of those mistakes that BYU will make early on into touchdowns and create some kind of cushion. So going into the fourth quarter, it's not 21-21, it's maybe we have a little cushion going into the fourth quarter. That's hopefully, I think that's what they need.
You know, you can look at this in two ways. You can say, well, the series has been so lopsided. The last Rainbow victory coming back in 1974 with Larry Price, the head coach, and the old Hula T. You could look at it that way and say, well, there's no reason for things to change given the fact that the Cougars have another one of those great quarterbacks and the Rainbows are coming off a shaky performance last week. The other side of it is the Rainbows are long overdue.
Yes. And another point I like to make, I feel a lot of those other games, the losses, we got out-coached. And I think a lot of fans here feel that we have been out-coached in past games. A key variable tonight is that the coaches have to out-coach the guys on the left of us here. Our coaches in green have to out-coach the coaches in blue and basically make those decisions that turn the game around.
The boos you hear are for the Cougars. They won the toss, and they elected to defer, so the Rainbows will receive the opening kickoff. And they'll do that when we come back after this.
They're back, the UH football rainbows and tailgating parties. For all your favorite foods to go, it's Marion's Catering. Select from Hawaiian favorites like Lomi Salmon, Poke, and Kalua Pig, or pick a sushi variety or great barbecue. Call Marion's Catering at 621-6758 for really special tailgating.
A look on the streets. The 1990 cars by Toyota are here, bringing a new decade of quality and style that you've come to expect from Toyota. And leading the way, the all-new Celica, with a bold, revolutionary design, unlike any car you've ever seen from Toyota. Catch catch a glimpse on the street. Then come in and see them all up close. The 1990s are here at your Toyota Hawaii dealers now.
Just moments away from the opening kickoff, the Rainbows against the Cougars of BYU. The Rainbows would like nothing better than after last week's poor performance on the road to come back this week with a big victory. Do you think, certainly you don't want to lose games, but that took some of the pressure off? Because if the Rainbows had won last week, this game would have been built up really with much more hype than we've seen this past week.
Yeah, this would have been one of those games for the WAC championship. With if University of Hawaii won last week, beat BYU, Air Force for the WAC championship, provided we beat El Paso. But this is it. The pressure's off, and this would make a lot of seasons out there for Coach Wagner. This would make his season. I don't care what he says. This would make his season and make a lot of senior seasons out there by beating BYU.
Weather tonight, 77 degrees. The humidity is 74%. The wind's out of the northeast at 9 miles an hour, and the forecast mostly fair. Jeff Seidner, the freshman, is back at the goal line for the Rainbows, awaiting the kickoff from Earl Kaufman. Seidner back there in place of Larry Conn-Smith, who got hurt last week. The ball is teed up. We are moments away from starting the UH-BYU clash. Kaufman into the ball, angles it deep. Seidner lets it bounce in the end zone, and that'll be it. He does not have to down the football. Once it goes into the end zone, it is downed. And so no return for the Rainbows. They will come out first and 10 at their own 20-yard line and have the ball there. And the Rainbows en masse are huddling with their offensive unit on the sideline, which is something different.
And I think they have to do a lot of things different.
Could this be a no-huddle attack? Yes, it is. Trips to the right side, a snake formation, and the Rainbows have one man to the left. In motion to the near side comes Dan Ahuna. Pop pass to Ahuna, 25, 30, up the field of 35. First down, Rainbows. After a gain of 15, they will go with a no-huddle attack, which is just what you and I were talking about this week.
We talked about this week with Don Robbs that they have to do things different. They're lining up in the snake. They're showing BYU something they haven't seen at all.
Gain of 15 on first and 10 for the Rainbows. Garrett Gabriel, the quarterback, trips to the left with Roscoe Ahuna. And one man also out there, and it goes to Seidner on the pass to the 35, the 40 on the left sideline, driven out of bounds at the 42. The Rainbows with a no-huddle attack. Brian Mitchell with the stop on the play, and it's razzle-dazzle time at Aloha. I tell you, after our conversation, I'm thrilled to see the Rainbows coming out with this formation. Gain of 8, so it'll be second and 2 for the Bows at their own 43-yard line, moving right to left. Ahuna in motion from the right side. Gabriel, short drop, throws a lateral to Seidner at the 38. Sidesteps one man up to the 40, 45, and the 47-yard line before finally being stopped by Eric Ferguson. The Rainbows are going with some quick hitch patterns on the sidelines, just two-yard patterns. Let Gabriel fire the ball to the sidelines, get the Cougars rattled.
And what they do, they pull the two near linemen to fight. It's a lineman's dream going out there and looking for a defensive back to hit him in his ear hole.
Another first down for the Rainbows, first and 10 from their own 47-yard line. Ahuna in motion. Three men to the left, and Gabriel on the option to the right slips down in the backfield and falls. A loss of a couple on the play as Bud Orr made penetration up the field. Orr, the left side defensive tackle. The Rainbows continue to go without a huddle. So it'll be second down and 12 for the Rainbows. Back on their own 45. Mahuka in motion out of the snake formation from the left side. Gabriel rolls that way. Fires to Roscoe. Complete at the 45 of BYU. And he's a yard shy of the first down. Tell me about the snake formation. Three men in a row split out wide.
What they're doing is they're going to do a combination of patterns. They'll send a motion here. And it's hard to defend because you have to line up as a snake defensive secondary. And it's what they're doing is they're working combination of patterns. And what the University of Hawaii is doing is reading patterns. They're lining up. They're seeing what kind of coverage, and they're reacting to their patterns according to the coverage given. And Gabriel's doing the same thing. He knows the patterns that the receivers should run.
A little bit of confusion here now as the Rainbows do huddle up on third and two from the Cougar 45 with Trips to the right, the snake to the right, Ohuna, the middleman in the snake, in motion back towards the formation. Gabriel fires to Roscoe, and a down and in at the 35, complete for another first down. Ferguson on the tackle. What does this do to BYU?
They're trying to regroup. You can see them after each play. They're talking to one another, the defensive backs, the free safeties, telling everybody, hey, we got to do this, we got to do this. They're not making adjustments. I think BYU should call a timeout.
Pickup of 10. First and 10 Rainbows on the 34 of the Cougars. Out of the snake to the left. In motion is Ohuna. Gabriel fires to the sideline to Mahuka. Complete the 30. Gets by one man. Spins down to the 26 before stopped by Davis. And a 9-yard pickup. The Rainbows are throwing just hitch patterns. Gabriel is taking the snap, taking one step backward and firing to the sidelines. And it's impossible for a defensive back, unless he reads the play, to be there. He's got to give some cushion. Trips to the right, the snake to the right for the Rainbows, with Roscoe, Ohuna, and Seidner there. Lau split left on second and two from the Cougar 26. Option to the left, Gabriel keeps the 20, the 15, stays on his feet, the 10, cuts back down to the 6-yard line. The Rainbows on the march on the opening drive. Stopped by Brian Mitchell, who saved the touchdown as Garrett Gabriel rumbled for 18 yards.
Garrett doing something he hasn't done all year, showing great moves on the back on downfield, making little cuts, getting the ball upfield, good blocking up front. That option was wide open off the left side.
And now the Rainbows go to their power eye formation with Jamal Farmer, who leads the team with 12 touchdowns on first and goal from outside the five. Jamal on the right side to the three, the two, and hit down at the 1-yard line as the Rainbows put Mark Odom in the backfield as a lead blocker. And they put that beef in the backfield and try to punch the ball in. It'll be second and goal from just outside the 1-yard line as Jamal Farmer is looking for his 13th touchdown of the season. Richard Stevenson is also in the backfield with Farmer and Odom on second and goal from the one. No score in the first quarter, opening drive. Farmer off the right tackle, up and over. Or is he? No signal yet. The Rainbow signal, and now the ref signals. Touchdown.
What's so good about that play, Larry? They ran right behind Goes and Jones as they normally do. BYU lines up Bob Davis right in the hole, puts Bud Orr right in the hole, and UH is matching strength against strength and marching the ball in the end zone. That builds up confidence, that builds up morale.
And the Rainbows now get set for the extra point, and with that touchdown, AmFac, JMB, Hawaii, and Liberty House donate $300 to the Touchdowns for Teaching program. AmFac, JMB, Hawaii, and Liberty House committed to excellence in education. The Rainbows take the opening kickoff and drive for 7. 7-0 Hawaii on the Rainbow Football Network.
You may think that the House of Soup serves only great oxtail or Portuguese soup. Well, think again. The House of Soup also serves breaded mahi-mahi and teriyaki steak plate lunches. Or you might order chicken katsu, hamburger steak, other local favorites served with rice and either tossed greens or macaroni salad. House of Soup with two locations on Union Mall in downtown or Baratania at the Old Graces location. House of Soup serving great local style plate lunches.
The 80s aren't over yet. And neither are the good deals your Toyota dealers have to offer on used cars. They're moving out a new fleet of 1988 used Toyotas at low, low prices. Over 200 Corolla sedans and Tercel coupes and five-door hatchbacks are now available. But the supply is limited, so you've got to move fast. Hurry to your nearest Toyota dealer now for one of the last great deals of the 80s.
Yes, you can do it. Win a 40-pound bag of Quikrete Vinyl Concrete Patcher every time the Rainbows sack the opposing team's quarterback. Just enter the Quikrete Sack It To 'Em contest. Find details in today's game program and in Hawaii Remodeling Magazine and the Honolulu Sporting News. Everyone who enters the Quikrete Sack It To 'Em contest is eligible to win a free trip for two to Molokai's Kalua Koi Resort.
You can do it. There's nothing to it.
7-0 Rainbows as they drive 80 yards down the field on their opening possession. hate to say I told you so, but Don Robbs, yours truly, and Larry Goes were at dinner last week and said, what do the Rainbows have to do? They've got to come out with the muddle huddle, the no huddle, do the unexpected. Don't run the fullback dive 100 times. And credit Paul Johnson.
Yes, he did exactly what Don Robbs wanted him to do. Don got the credit. I think Don had a talk with Paul and said, Paul, this is what you got to do. I may not know a thing, but this is what you have to do.
Jason Elam kicking off. It is high, but it is short. It is taken at the 9-yard line by Tony Crutchfield. Angling left, runs into his own blocker and run down from behind at the 22-yard line. And the Rainbows, Joe Sardo down on special teams coverage along with Jerry Winfrey, they are a fired up bunch.
What you're seeing down there is people throwing their bodies around. Talking to Coach Ellison, the defensive coordinator, he says, we're not going to let them bleed us. We're not going to play zone. We're going to put a lot of pressure. We're going to blitz them. We're going to fly around. And that's what they have to do to have a chance of stopping BYU.
14-yard return for Crutchfield out to the 23-yard line. The Cougars trailing 7-0 here in the first quarter, 11:15 to play in this period, and the fans want defense. Split backs behind Ty Detmer on first and 10. Toss sweep to the left to Bellini. Around the left side, hit at the 23, gets to the 26-yard line, and he was dragged down on the play by Mark Odom, the outside linebacker, 5'11", 217, a junior from Long Beach. Was a pickup of 3 on the play for Bellini.
Talk about David and Goliath. There's a lot of Davids down there playing against a lot of Goliaths. BYU is far bigger, but what the Rainbows are doing are running. They're running to the ball. They're not lining up playing head up there. Right on that first play, they're shooting gaps.
Second and 7 for the Cougars, moving left to right from their own 26. Rainbows shift their defensive line just before the snap of the ball. Back to pass, Detmer, draw to Whittingham, runs into his own man, hit and then dropped by Joaquin Barnett. And a lot of friends, Mike Tressler up quickly, filling from his safety spot at the 28-yard line. And Whittingham that time was slowed up by one of his own blockers.
He ran into the back of big number 64,
Mohammed. Can you say his last
name?
No, I practiced all week.
Mohammed. I like Mohammed.
They call him Big Mo, and Big E is Mohammed Elouanibi, 6'5", 290, a senior. Third and 5 for the Cougars on their own 28-yard line. Rainbows with a 4-man front, shifting at the line, and Detmer drops back to pass. Heavy rush. He fires. It is complete to Boyce at the 40-yard line and wrapped up by Mike Colson and dropped there. First down Cougars as they converted on a 12-yard completion. Andy Boyce, the junior from Salt Lake City, on the completion, but a penalty marker is down. And here's Pat Sweeney to tell us we've got holding against the Rainbows.
On the defense, penalty is declined. They accept the game. First down.
You know, that play, Larry, Ty Detmer really showed that poise. He just sat in his pocket, knowing that Mark Odom was going to lay a lick on him, and just bid time to just throw that pass, and he got a hit. He got whacked right in the mouth.
First and 10 as the penalty is declined. First and 10 from the 41-yard line of BYU. In motion to the near side comes Jeff Franson, the wide receiver. They run a pitch to this side. Bellini trying to turn the corner, and he's knocked out of bounds by Walter Briggs at the 44 of Hawaii. Pickup of 3. Do you think the Cougars can run the football against this scrappy Rainbow defense?
Well, if you look at just their size, you would say they should be able to run the ball. Coach Edwards, talking before the game, Coach Edwards said, we have to run the ball. We're going to try to put the ball on the ground and try to see if we can march up the field and get some yardage on the ground. So they're going to try. I would think the Rainbow's going to rise to the occasion and run the ball down.
Give Bellini a pickup of 4 on that carry, so it's 2nd and 6 from the Cougar 45. Back split behind Detmer, and now we got 2 men in motion. They look a little confused. Penalty marker down. Bellini on a sweep left. Hit and dropped at the 45-yard line. Augie Apelu in pursuit ran him down, the big senior from San Jose. But I think this one, well, the Rainbows will have a decision to make because the penalty will likely be against BYU.
And they should decline it.
Since they stopped the ball carrier for no gain, would set up 3rd and 6, decline the penalty.
Illegal shift on the offense. Penalty is declined. 3rd down.
You know, on that play, Augie Apelu is showing what Rainbows may have over BYU speed. He does a good job of getting off the block and works his way down, works his way right along the line of scrimmage and cutting off the man
at the pass. And then you also had David Maeva there. The Rainbows are definitely a lot faster than BYU.
Third and six for the Cougars. First quarter of play, they trail 7-0. Double wide receiver to the left. Whittingham the single setback as Bellini now comes in motion from left to right. Rainbows blitz. Detner rolls left, fires to the sideline left, complete. And good enough? No! Out of bounds was Matt Odell. And Odell can't believe it, right in front of the Rainbow bench. And one of the refs was right on the spot and said, sorry, you came down out of bounds. Would have been good enough for a first down at the Rainbow 45. Instead, the Rainbows will get the football back as the punting unit comes on for BYU. And here is Earl Kaufman, the sophomore from Texas, averaging almost 42 yards per punt. He gets it off. The Rainbows have two men back. Seidner watches it bounce, takes it on the run at the 8-yard line to the 10, spins back against the grain, has a hole, can't get away though at the 12-yard line. He did a 180, and now we've got a little pushing and shoving, and we'll likely have a personal foul penalty.
I think they're going to call one on 44 for BYU. He looked like he threw a good left hook.
Stacy Corley made the tackle on Jeff Seidner as Seidner was doing whatever he could, getting real creative to try to get away. The penalty marker against, if you say it's 44, Byron Beatty.
Or Haku.
Personal foul against the Rainbows and against BYU, so they will offset each other. And in essence, there's no point in throwing the penalty marker, but Byron Beatty coming home.
Being a little home, maybe I didn't see Haku's left hook, only saw the other guy's right hook, so.
Well, you only see the hooks from the guys in blue. That was a 47-yard punt and a 4-yard return. Rainbows again go with the snake formation on first and 10 from their own 13-yard line. Three men in a row out to the right side, and Leonard Lau split wide to the left. Gabriel, the quarterback, runs Farmer off the right side. Hole at the 10, Stutter steps to the 20-yard line. And he has got a pickup of 7 on the play. And the Rainbows, I don't know, can they go with this formation the whole game?
Well, you know, what the formation forces BYU to do, they force us to take one of their middle linebackers and put him out in the flats. So they are able to run the ball also. BYU has to. They have to put Bob Davis way out there.
And take him out of the play. Pickup of 8. So it'll be 2nd and 2 Rainbows. Hand off Farmer. Big hole over the left side. He's got the first down. They grab him by an ankle and drop him at the 25. That was a pickup of 8 yards. Check it. That was a pickup of 3 yards. Kalfusi on the stop for BYU. 1st and 10, Hawaii on their own 25-yard line, leading 7-0 with a unique look tonight. Handoff Farmer up the middle, and whoa, nothing doing this time as he runs right into Bud Orr, and Orr says, well, you fooled us the last time, but not right now. And Orr, 6'6", 265, the senior from Salt Lake City, gets a grasp and does not let go of Jamal Farmer. Call it a gain of 1 on the play, so the Bows, as they huddle up, will be facing 2nd and 9 from their own 26. Rainbow football brought to you by Roberts Hawaii, the official travel agent of the KHVH football broadcast team. And now for the first time, the Rainbows go to the double slot, 2nd and 8 from their 27. Handoff Farmer up the middle to the 30, lunging 35, still on his feet to the 40. Oh, tremendous leg drive by Jamal Farmer, stopped by Norman Dixon, the strong safety. But Jamal appeared to be in a wedge and just hung up, and it appeared he was going down and popped out of there.
And what that wedge was that Larry Jones, Sean Olivato, and Alan Smith in front of him just pushing and pushing. And the Rainbows on two successful running plays, pushing BYU off the line of scrimmage.
Gain of 14 for Jamal Farmer, the freshman, who could have a hand in a big, big win tonight if the Rainbows can keep going. Farmer up the middle, and he's struggling for yardage on a handoff to the 43-yard line, stopped by Big Dwayne Johnson. Seems like every tackler is a big guy for BYU. 6'5", 244, a senior, is Dwayne Johnson from Provo, Utah. Pickup of 4 on the play.
This is a typical BYU game, because after each play, you see some green jersey pushing some white jersey, and then vice versa. A lot of shoving going after the play down there.
Again, the Rainbows have now gone to their double slot, and it looks like single coverage with Roscoe being guarded by Brian Mitchell on the left side. Gabriel runs the option right, pitches at the 45 to MacArthur, who's run out of bounds at midfield, right at the 50-yard stripe. I believe he will be just shy of the first down, stopped by Troy Fuller.
Rainbows complaining there. They think the referee took about a half yard away.
So it'll be third down and a short one for the Rainbows, who lead 7-0 here in the first quarter with 6:23 to play in the period. And Mark Odom has checked into the backfield for the Rainbows, who apparently will go to the power eye set with Richard Stevenson, Odom, and Farmer behind the quarterback Garrett Gabriel. Strength against strength right here. Handoff, Farmer over the top and barely, I don't know, he's still struggling and fighting. It'll be very close depending on where they spot the ball. You may have heard the Cougar coaches to our left feeling that the Rainbow's left side moved prematurely and should have been given a penalty. No penalty, in fact, it's a first down as the refs signal that Farmer did get the necessary yardage.
Tell me the truth, did you see anybody move?
Well, it was infinitesimal. I mean, it was a split second early. To the naked eye, almost indiscernible.
Their eyes are naked, that's for sure.
7-0 Rainbows, first and 10 at the midfield stripe. Moving from right to left here in the first quarter. Gabriel, play action fake. Looking down the sideline right, throws short to the right side in a hitch pattern. MacArthur dancing away to the 45, down the sideline to the 41 before being driven out of bounds by Dwayne Johnson. Good play by Gabriel, who took a hit after he threw the ball. He was looking deep down the field, saw his men were covered, checked off and threw to...
Showing a good presence of mind there, not forcing anything, because the last thing you want is a turnover here. We got the momentum. Let's keep it going. Great job by Garrett.
Through to his swing man, MacArthur, for a pickup of 6. Call it second down and long 3 for the Rainbows on the Cougar 42. Jeff Newman in the game at slot back as Gabriel runs the option, tucks it up and keeps and gets the first down over the right side, just inside the 40-yard line. And, you know, you really get the feeling at this point as Shad Hansen, the freshman from Danville, California, makes the stop, that the Rainbows have BYU completely off balance.
Coach, credit Coach Johnson. He came out with the snake. He's playing with their mind a little. That he's forcing them to do different things that they're not used to doing on defense, and creating something out there. And you've definitely seen a different team.
Gain of 4 for Garrett Gabriel, who did tuck the ball away and secure it as he was going down. First and 10 Rainbows on the Cougar 39-yard line. On the march here again on their second possession, leading 7-0 in the first quarter. Ahuna in motion from right to left. Gabriel rolls that way, throws on the run to the sideline. Roscoe juggles at the sideline and can't hang on. Incomplete at the 25-yard line. Guarded by Brian Mitchell and Troy Fuller over there, but Roscoe should have caught that one, and he would tell you that himself.
He's kind of walking back to the huddle saying, sorry, Garrett, I didn't mean to do that.
Good block by Jamal Farmer, taking out Bob Davis, who was in pursuit of Gabriel on the play. Servco Office Systems is your authorized dealer of Ricoh copiers and fax machines. Ricoh, quality products backed by professionals. Second and 10 Rainbows at the BYU 39 from the double slot. Gabriel, is this a shovel pass? Yes, it is to Mahuka. 40, 35, running to the left of the sidelines. The 30, 25, lowers the shoulder at the 22. Run out of bounds by Brian Mitchell. First down Rainbows as they caught the Cougars up the field and beat them with the shovel pass.
Does a good job just staying behind his blockers and making a burst to the outside, seeing he has a lane and just taking that alley and just trying to press the ball downfield.
Pickup of 17 for the junior from Nanakuli High School. He can run, and we saw that acceleration. He held the state record in the 100-meter dash, and you could see that speed right there. First and 10 Rainbows at the 22-yard line of BYU. Farmer up the middle, gets maybe to the 19-yard line, smothered in a blanket of white. Tim Adams, the nose tackle, along with Shad Hansen there. Adams, 6'4", 285, a senior from Cimarron, Kansas. 3-yard gain on the play, so it'll be second and 7 for the Rainbows. From the BYU 19-yard line, Hawaii leading 7-0 here in a first quarter that they have completely dominated. Roscoe to the left. Leonard Lau to the right. Rainbow's in the double slot. Inside handoff, Farmer now running out wide to the right. Flag goes down as Farmer is run out of bounds and thrown to the sidelines. And the fans want a penalty marker for that. Loss on the play as they threw him out at the 21. Bob Davis, the boss of BYU, making his presence felt there. I think there was premature movement by the Rainbows. It'll probably be procedure, illegal motion against the Rainbows, but they may decline the penalty.
It's going to be someone on the right side. It was either tackle guard on the right side.
Illegal motion on the offense. Penalty's declined. Third down.
Farmer there on that play doing some ad-libbing because it was designed as a trap to run up the middle. He decided to bounce it wide and ran into a whole lot of white shirts. It was a loss of one on the play, so it'll be third and eight for the Rainbows from the Cougar 20-yard line. Triple wide receiver to the left with Roscoe, Ahuna, and MacArthur there. Gabriel sets up, looking over the middle, fires complete at the six-yard line. Leonard Lau with a leaping grab, a beautiful catch as he was drilled on the reception by Bob Davis and Eric Ferguson. And Garrett Gabriel threw a missile right into the thick of coverage and got away with it, and Lau made a brilliant reception. First and goal Rainbows at the 6-yard line. Lau, who came into this game with only two catches the entire season, one of them coming last week against the Rams of CSU, makes a big grab there for a first down. A 14-yard pickup, and the Rainbows again are knocking on the door. First and goal out of the power eye. Farmer to the five and runs into a whole gang of people stuck in the middle of the field like a jigsaw puzzle all meshed together. Chad Robinson at the bottom of the pile for the Cougars on the tackle. Going to be hard for the Rainbows to run up the middle with that much beef in there.
And they're bringing their short yardage offense on the 6-yard line. I would think they want to use it inside the five. They have a lot of confidence in it. And what they might want to do is something totally different from this formation. Keep the ball through a pass or get it on the outside.
Stevenson, Odom, and Farmer in the power eye set. Strong to the right on second and goal from the five. Handoff. Pitch to Farmer, hit in the backfield, trying to stay on his feet, and he's dropped back at the 10 for a loss of 6 on the play. Bob Davis not fooled at all as the Rainbows tried to go wide with it, and Farmer just had nowhere to go.
Davis lined it up right over the guard and blitzed right on the snap of the ball. Good play by Bob Davis.
Loss of 3 on the play, and the Rainbows pushed back. Now third and goal from the 8. They lead 7-0 with 2:48 and ticking left to play in the first quarter. They drove 80 yards on their opening possession. They took over possession on this drive at their own 13, and now the Rainbows want timeout. 7-0 Hawaii on the Rainbow Football Network.
From NFL and collegiate action to the OIA, Oceanic Cable is your football headquarters. Get into the excitement of high school football from Aloha Stadium every week on Cable 17. And be sure to support Oahu's public schools by attending OIA events. Remember, school spirit promotes personal pride in our young people.
Catch the OIA quarterfinal football playoffs on Oceanic Cable, Channel 17, November 2nd and 3rd, live from Aloha Stadium.
This broadcast is being sponsored in part by the UH Professional Assembly, the faculty union. It's the faculty's way of saying, we believe in excellence, on the football field as well as in the classroom. Athletics and academics, together and in balance, help to produce a complete university, just as they help to produce a complete individual. And that will mean quality higher education for Hawaii's youth for years to come. Now, that really is something to cheer about.
Subway bakes my bread up fresh, and that's my way.
My way.
I get a combo seafood club the best way. My way.
Subway.
My sub in front of me. Just the way it ought to be.
Subways are right on your way with 19 stores on Oahu. Accept no substitute.
Rainbows facing a critical third and goal from the 8 situation here. Leading 7-0 right now. We'll pause for station identification on the Rainbow Football Network.
All you need to know. KHVH News Radio. 99.
KHVH.
KHVH, Honolulu.
All right, Coach Goas, what do you like here?
Heck, I don't know.
Thanks for being so decisive.
I would get Gabriel on the perimeter, get him outside, look for Roscoe, look for the slots, but you don't want to throw an interception. Tell Garrity, if it's open, throw it. If not, throw it away.
Rainbows are on the right hash mark. They line up Roscoe wide left and bring him in motion back towards the formation. Now he goes back to the left. Gabriel takes the snap, rolls left, fires to Roscoe wide open. Touchdown!
That's what I would have called right there.
He was wide open as the Cougars were confused. Norman Dixon and Irvin Lee had no clue in the defensive secondary. Roscoe lined up wide left, as we said, ran back towards the formation. BYU must have thought, whoever was supposed to guard him, thought that he was going to be somebody else's responsibility. He ran back out to the left side and was wide open. Gabriel hit him. Touchdown. And with that touchdown, Amfac, JMB, Hawaii, and Liberty House donate another $300 to UH. They're all committed to excellence in education. Jason Elam, extra point is good. 14-0 Rainbows with 2:34 to play first quarter on the Rainbow Football Network.
Your Toyota Hawaii dealers are celebrating Servco's 70th year with an anniversary value package on all 1990 Corollas and Camrys. For just $70, your value package may include power steering, AM/FM stereo, power windows, aluminum wheels, and more, saving you over $800 on certain models. Offer ends November 30th and supplies are limited. So hurry to your Toyota dealers now.
I love what you do.
Most Rainbow fans already know that Pacific Machinery is Hawaii's exclusive distributor for Caterpillar, from heavy construction machines and the 416 backhoe to Caterpillar lift trucks, engines, and energy systems. But did you also know that Pacific Machinery is Hawaii's distributor for Toro, International Truck, Bobcat, Kubota Farm Tractors, Cushman Utility Vehicles, The Green Machine, Ingersoll Rand, and more? In fact, we handle over 50 major manufacturers. Like the Rainbows, it's an impressive team. Pacific Machinery, we sell lease, rent, and service machines that make the Pacific work.
Only one airline offers business class service on every flight leaving Honolulu. It also flies frequent schedules to Los Angeles, San Francisco, Denver, and provides convenient connections to over 100 mainland cities. For 20 years, this airline has provided warm and caring service to Hawaii's travelers. The airline? Continental. And Hawaii is going places on Continental Airlines.
14-0 Rainbows as Garrett Gabriel hits Chris Roscoe on an 8-yard strike, and Roscoe takes it in for the touchdown. Garrett's numbers, he's now 10 of 11 in the air for 101 yards and 2 touchdowns as Jason Elam boots the ball away. It is sky high, end over end, but short, taken by Crutchfield at the 14, angles to the left. Here come the Rainbows. Sean Abreu at the 22-yard line runs him down and drops him. Funny story about Sean. Last year against BYU, he was out on special teams coverage, and Sean got hit in the head. Trainers looked at him, they said, do you know where you are? He said, Aloha Stadium. What's your name? Sean Abreu. Who are we playing? Sean looks out on the field, he's in a daze, sees blue, sees white, says, Kamehameha? Trainers say, get off the field, you're not playing again tonight. First and 10, Cougars at their own 22. Unaccustomed to a 14-0 deficit. Detmer sidesteps on Diapelo. Hits tight end Smith on the right side. Lots of running room, 30, 35. And he is dropped at the 41-yard line by Walter Briggs. And a first down for the Cougars. Colson also on the tackle. Tell me about the touchdown pass for the Rainbows.
Okay, first of all, that's the first time the Rainbows send Chris Roscoe in motion. On goal line defense, you're always playing a man-to-man defense, and you're communicating. The outside cornerback's communicating with the safety. Roscoe goes in motion and says, their man has made a check, so you got him. But when he comes back, both of them, they make the check back, and they both went with Ahuna, the slot, and left Roscoe all alone.
First and 10, BYU after a 19-yard pickup. Draw to Whittingham, hit by Talley and dropped after a gain of one, maybe two. Also there quickly, Dana Directo, to get a hand on the running back, Whittingham, who plays fullback for BYU. I'm really surprised that Dana is even in the lineup for this game. I saw him at the airport after the game at Colorado State. He was on crutches, had a badly bruised thigh. He was
I mean, all messed up. His left ankle was badly turned. He said, hey, this is my last chance at the Cougars. I'll be out there, and he is. Second and 8 for BYU at their own 43. Play action fake. Detmer rolls left. Joaquin Barnett in pursuit. Can't get there. Thrown up the field. Bellini, a diving catch at the 30-yard line. Complete as he beat Mark Odom, linebacker who could not stay with Bellini. But a flag is down, and I think it's going to be against the Rainbows for a late hit.
They're going to call roughing the passer.
Well, that'll be tacked on to the play. Nice reception, and Detmer could see Joaquin Barnett racing in at him. Here's Pat Sweeney, the official, with the call. Well, he gave us the hand signal, and this will march the ball all the way to the 15-yard line. So quickly, the Cougars responding here, trailing 14-0 with 1:14 to play in the first quarter. Brooks Baer on the sidelines had a good view of it.
Yeah, definitely roughing the passer on Joaquin Barnett. Joaquin came in a little late, gave him a chuck in the back, and Detmer went flying.
First and 10, Cougars from the 15-yard line of Hawaii. Back split, Whittingham and Bellini behind Ty Detmer. Double wide receiver to the left, Detmer back to pass, pumps to the right side, looking, gets away. No, he won't. Thrown down and sacked on the play by Augie Apelu, who was being held and horse-collared. The flag is down. Boy, he was being tackled in the backfield.
Jim Poffo, their offensive guard, had Augie by his horse collar, really had him by his horse collar and dragging him.
Oh, but there's also a penalty against the Rainbows, which will nullify the play. They threw one flag at the 6-yard line, which had to be on a defensive back, trying to stop a wide receiver while Augie was being held.
On the offense, holding on the defense, penalties offset, no first down.
So the sack does not count, and it will remain first and 10 for BYU on the Hawaii 15. Rainbows with a 14-0 lead, under a minute to play in the first quarter. Brett Nyberg, along with Andy Boyce on the left side, back to pass. Detmer facing a big rush, scrambling to the right, won't get away, fumbles, loose ball, the Rainbows may have it, and they do at the 13-yard line. Mark Odom running down Ty Detmer from behind. Of these fans,
they got something to be happy about. Mark runs Detmer down from behind. Detmer trying to avoid it. Mark sticks his hand, rips the ball, and there's three Rainbows there to recover the ball. Augie Apelu comes up with the football.
Well, the senior from San Jose, who just had a sack taken away from him, comes up with something more valuable, the football. And we've got an injured Rainbow. Looks like Apelu or Maeva. We'll see which one might be hurt after that big pile up at the 13-yard line.
David Maeva holding his shoulder, his right shoulder.
He has a torn rotator cuff, so that's something he's going to have to deal with all season long. And that's the first turnover of the game with 39 seconds left in the first quarter, and the Rainbows at their own 14-yard line, again, go with that snake formation. Three receivers to the right. They run Farmer up the middle. Actually, it's Lamar Young who is checked in at the 16-yard line for a gain of 2. And so the Rainbows went 80 yards with this formation and the no-huddle attack on their first series. They will try it again, although now they are going to the huddle. Rainbow football brought to you by Pacific Machinery, from bulldozers to lawnmowers, machines that make the Pacific work. Pacific Machinery, a division of Theo H. Davies and Company Limited. That may be the final play of the first quarter as they let the clock run out. 14-0 Rainbows after one period of play on the Hawaii Football Network.
This is the sound of an office without a Ricoh copier.
So, Sid, can you fix the copier again?
1 o'clock, sure.
Oh, yeah, well, your toolbox is still here from yesterday. Listen, how did little Sid do on that math test?
If you're getting to know your copier repairman a little too well, call your authorized Ricoh copier dealer. He can help.
Sid, you maniac, you told me that one last week.
Ricoh, we don't let your office get in the way of your business.
Call Servco Office Systems, your authorized Ricoh dealer, 847-5731.
KHVH welcomes Sir Kenjo's Lunch House and Lunch Wagon as UH Rainbow supporters. When you're cruising in Kaka'ako and get the munchies for some Ono-licious food, stop by either Sir Kenjo's Lunch House on Cook and Queen Street or Sir Kenjo's Red Lunch Wagon at Queen and Ward. You'll know the place. Just look for the crowd gathering for Sir Kenjo's famous plate lunches. Sir Kenjo's features roast pork, teriyaki steak, beef stew. The list goes on and on. So when you have the lunchtime hungries, remember, Sir Kenjo's Lunch House and Lunch Wagon.
Attorney John Channon on what the client can expect from his offices.
They'll find an advocate who is going to go the whole way with them, who is going to represent them from beginning to end, who's going to be able to articulate their position, sympathetic and sensitive to their needs, to try to do the best job that we can do, and be tireless and a fighter and an advocate for them.
John Channon, attorney at law, offices in Honolulu and on Kauai.
14-0 Rainbows after one quarter of play. The Rainbows with two long drives. Jamal Farmer with a touchdown run. And Gabriel Tarasco on a TD pass. And the Rainbows, who were 4.5-point dogs, up by two TDs. You know, I almost didn't make it to this game.
How come?
Well, this morning, I was staying at my brother's house. And I was staying downstairs because I'm moving tomorrow. I'm moving to the mainland. And I walked into the bathroom this morning, closed the door, and the door handle came off in my hand. I was stuck in there, and I was pounding on the door. Nobody was around. My sister-in-law was on the upper floor of the house, and I'm thinking, well, I'm going to have to break the door down. I'm going to be trapped in here. I could be here for days. Finally, I was knocking, help, help, and she finally came and rescued me. Thought I was a cat scratching at the screen door. I'm glad I made it, I'll tell you. 14-0 Rainbows. And it has been not only an entertaining first quarter of play, but the Rainbows have given fans something so totally different that you can't help but enjoy watching this.
Well, we talked about coaching, and the coaches have to play a major role. What the coaches have done with the snake offense is allow the University of Hawaii to use their speed, their open feet speed, that they, you know, have a tremendous advantage over BYU. The snake takes Bob Davis out of the running defense, and they have done that with coaching. Great move by them.
Rainbows go back to their more usual formation. Trips to the right, Roscoe to the left on 2nd and 7. Option Gabriel, and he is hit and dropped on the play on the left sideline by Shad Hansen. And Gabriel, I think, had his helmet ripped off as well. Almost beheaded on the play. So the Rainbows, after a pickup of really nothing on the play, will put Jamal Farmer back in the tailback position. Lamar Young heads to the sidelines. And it's 3rd and 7. Rainbows have to be careful here because they're deep in their own territory. Lau and MacArthur to the right, along with Ahuna. Roscoe wide left for Gabriel on 3rd and 7 from his own 17. Back to pass he goes. Screen to Farmer on the right side. Big hole, 15, 20. Has a blocker in front. Cuts back at the 30, the 35. He could go all the way. 40, 50. There's 2 men in front. The 30, the 25, 20, 10. Cuts back the 5. Leaps.
He catches the screen, stays behind Sean Robinson. Sean makes a block, makes a cut, and then follows Chris Roscoe, who's going down the field with Mitchell, and just patty-caking, and Leo's down there patty-caking, and he punches in the end zone.
And with that touchdown, Amfac JMB Hawaii and Liberty House donated another $300 to the University of Hawaii. All committed to excellence in education. Extra point by Jason Elam is good. 21-0 Rainbows on the Hawaii Football Network.
It's over your head, it's on every side. Mountains of veggies and fruit to the sky. Come take a look, come see the difference that Safeway
Safeway is the place to go for garden fresh fruit and vegetables your whole family will enjoy. Safeway's produce makes a difference you can see and a difference that you'll taste. And you'll like Safeway's super special on fresh papayas. They're Hawaii grade A, king of the tropical fruits. Smooth, sweet meat, a breakfast treat. So tasty anytime you want a refreshing, healthy snack. And right now, 3 pounds of this locally grown favorite are just $1 at Safeway. So pick Hawaii's own. Pick papaya. You'll taste the difference.
Come take a look. Come see the difference at Safeway.
Take advantage of this terrific special on Hawaii Grade A fresh papayas. Through Tuesday at all Oahu Safeway stores.
Francis Camera gives you a closer look at rainbow sports action with the state's largest binocular selection. Bushnell, Pentax, Tasco, and Nikon will zoom you onto the field or floor. Minolta, Steiner, Leica, and Fuji will give you the angle on a great player scoring points. Binoculars from Francis Camera start at $30. For the best seat in the house, get binoculars from Francis Camera. One of over 180 Ala Moana stores.
Nothing Rainbows here in the second quarter. Great job of downfield blocking by Chris Roscoe, who, as you put it, was patty caking Brian Mitchell down the field for about 20 yards. Your big brother Leo finished off Mr. Mitchell. Credit Jamal Farmer with a nice leap and cut back inside the 10 to take it all the way, 83 yards. Garrett Gabriel is now 11 of 12 passing for 184 yards and 2 touchdowns. Who would believe it? 21-0 Rainbows. And boy, this does not look too much like the team we saw at Colorado State.
Not at all. And it's so good to see, because you can see some frustration getting out here. And it's only going to build. They have to keep the momentum.
Elam kicks off high and deep. Crutchfield at the 4, up to the 10. Running to the left. Oh, he's drilled at the 15-yard line. Terry Whitaker and Tony Goodenay combining on the stop.
And Pat Gordon lines up on his far left side as the number one man and just shows tremendous speed running down the field, running around all the blockers and hitting the return man on the 15-yard line.
Holding him to an 11-yard return. That is excellent special teams coverage. Could be a lot of partying tonight, and a real winner knows how to party right. So please, use good sense when you drink. Know when to say when. A reminder from your friends at Anheuser-Busch. 13:55 to play. First half. 21-0 Rainbows. Cougars with the ball, moving right to left from their own 16. Detmer on the draw to Whittingham. Hitting the backfield. Spins away. Runs into Tressler and several other Rainbows. And Colson finally finishes him off. As the Rainbows are swarming to the football, Joaquin Barnett among those at the bottom of the pile.
That was Manly Williams getting the back, but he lines up on his left tackle and just shoots the gap. And what speed, what he needs to do is make the tackle, however. But he just gets to the backfield in a hurry.
Pickup of 1 on the play, so it'll be 2nd down and 9. The field littered with confetti at this point, as there's been a lot of celebrating. And now the officials are telling the Cougars to get back off of the field. On the sideline, there's
that white strip. They have no player can be in that white solid strip. That's only for coaches.
They are crowding the field, and so the officials tell them to get back. Rainbows, a fired up unit at this point, leading by 3 touchdowns. 2nd and 9 for BYU from their own 17. Gavin Robertson now in at right side linebacker for the Rainbows. Joaquin Barnett is in the middle as the Rainbows are showing a 6-man front. Back to pass goes Detmer. Has time. Throws down the middle for Bellini. Complete. The 50. Cuts back 45, 40, 30. And driven out of bounds at the 22-yard line by Walter Briggs. Well, Bellini had single coverage, and it was a perfect pass by Ty Detmer. And boy, you talk about a quick strike.
Coming back in a hurry. But the Rainbows are in an all-out blitz. They're sitting Joaquin Barnett. What they must do, they must put pressure on Detmer. BYU picks up the blitz. Detmer has no pressure at all. He's able to find Bellini one-on-one.
And the man he beat was Mike Tressler, who was upset with himself. You know, it was not bad coverage. It was a perfectly thrown...
You couldn't throw the ball any better than that.
Perfectly thrown ball lofted. That was a pickup of 71 yards. First and 10. Cougars now at the Rainbow 22. They show blitz. Detmer with a short drop fires right to the 20-yard line, complete, and a big hit by Tressler and Colson as they take Brett Nyberg and ride him right into the turf. Pickup of 3.
Well, we talked to Coach Ellison yesterday, Larry, and he said, hey, I'm not going to let BYU go down 5, 6, 7 yards. I'm going to put a lot of pressure, and if they're going to beat us, they're going to beat us with big plays. We're going to force them to throw the ball deep, and that's the only way he can play this team.
12:37 to play first half. 21-0 Rainbows over BYU. Whittingham in motion from right to left. Toss sweep left to Bellini, trying to get outside. Good block by Whittingham. The 20, the 16. Oh, big hit on the play. Excellent pursuit by Manley Williams down the line as he jumped on the back of Bellini along with Kim McLeod. And what could have been a big play to the outside is stopped. And that was a pickup of only 2. Excellent speed by the Rainbows. Showed on that play.
Running it down. And on a toss sweep, what you want to force the offense to stretch the play laterally. Don't allow them to turn up the field too quick.
Third and 4 for BYU at the Rainbow 16-yard line. Rainbows with a 6-man front. Back to pass goes Detmer. Looking down the middle, throws to the left, and it's up in the air, almost intercepted and incomplete. Brett Nyberg at the 6-yard line did a button hook, guarded by Kim McLeod. Nyberg turned back in towards the field for the football. It was thrown slightly to the outside. He juggled. Nyberg couldn't hang on. McLeod had a shot at it. Would have been a great interception and could not make it. So it's now 4th and 4, and we'll see the field goal unit for BYU.
And credit David Stanton on that play, getting in and putting a little pressure on Ty Detmer, forcing him to throw the ball quicker than he wanted to.
Jason Chaffetz will come on and attempt a 35-yard field goal from the left hash mark. Good snap, good hold. There's a kick. Oh, this is very weak. May not make it. No good. Wide to the right. But a flag is down. A flag is down. It could be Burton roughing or running into the kicker or the holder. And that's what it is. Oh, a freshman mistake. As James Burton, who is one of the swiftest Rainbows, lines up on a wing and tries to cut the corner as quickly as he can, stretch out and block the kick. And he did not get a piece of the ball, but he went plowing in to the holder as well as Chaffetz. Now, if he was blocked in, there would be no penalty. But in this case, he just came flying in out of control.
And Coach Wagner's upset because I haven't seen a replay or anything, but he's just really upset. Now, James Burton is the designated block man on that play. He's coming for the ball every time.
It is called running into the kicker, and he barely hit Chaffetz, who, as we look at the replay, courtesy of KHNL, got a foot to knock Chaffetz off balance, but Chaffetz could get an Academy Award performance. First down, Cougars. So instead of getting 0, they may get something. Detmer bootlegs out to the left. All day to throw at the 17-yard line, scrambling around, throws to Whittingham at the 15. He's dodging Rainbows and gets down inside the 10 to the 9. Dropped by Colson. Credit Ty Detmer with great poise. He faked a handoff, bootlegged out to the left side, stood there for what seemed like an eternity, motioned to receivers, no Rainbow pass rush, motioned to guys to run to the right, then hit Whittingham across the field, and he got it for a pickup of 3. That's poise not normally shown by a sophomore quarterback.
Good presence of mind.
2nd and 7 from the Rainbow 9. Cougars with new life here after penalty, and now they're going to be penalized. Neil Fort and Jim Bomforth movement on the line for BYU.
What's
dead ball? Ball start on the offense. 5 yards penalty.
What's happening down there, Larry? The Rainbows are shifting. They're shifting front. So what's causing the BYU to do? They're making their audible calls on the line of scrimmage. Their center is telling their guard who to block, and they're confirming it. And through all that confusion, when they see the movement, they're jumping off sides. And that's so just purely caused by just they're confused right there on that play.
So the penalty makes it 2nd and 12 for the Cougars back on the Rainbow 14-yard line. Double wide receiver to the right. Now one of them, Bellini, comes in motion to the left. Whittingham single setback as Dettmer drops back, pumps. Now will scramble out to the left side. He has good speed at the 15, being pursued to 10, the 5, and knocked out of bounds on the left sideline by Manly Williams. They'll spot it at the 4-yard line. That is not good enough for a first down. It will be third down and 2 for BYU. And they trail 21-0. Dettmer is dangerous.
Yes, he has the ability to throw, he has the ability to run, keep his poise. Coach Edwards said he's a lot like McMahon with his mental toughness. He's not easily rattled at all. And, you know, he's short there making some individual plays out there.
He was the WAC Player of the Week last week after throwing for 426 yards against UTEP, a 3-TD performance. Third and 2 for BYU on the Rainbow 4. Handoff, Whittingham up the middle, hit by Williams, surges on the second effort and may have gotten the first down. Manley did not wrap his arms around the ball carrier Whittingham, who may remind some of the human bowling ball Don Nottingham, who used to play for the Colts, very similar in build, 5'10", 200 pounds. And depending on where they spot the ball, looks like this is going to be a first down.
Manley makes good contact at the point of attack. He just doesn't bring his arms with him. He's just leading with his head. Good contact.
It is a first down, so it'll be first and goal for BYU inside the 2. They trail 21-0 with 10:15 to play here in the first half.
Now, you want to talk about momentum and poise and just having just continued drive down the... This is an important series right here. If the Rainbows can hold here, which is a tough challenge, if they can hold here, they would have a lot more momentum going into the finishing off this quarter.
Whittingham and Bellini in the backfield along with Peter Tuipulotu, who lines up as a wing back on the left side. On first and goal from the 2, Whittingham. No, it's Bellini twisting in, touchdown off the left side. Terry Whitaker had a leg but couldn't wrap him up. BYU gets in the end zone, taking advantage of what really was a ticky-tack penalty on James Burton.
Now, Burton first was blocked, and if anything, he might have hit the toe of Jason Chaffetz. He might have hit the toe where he was planted, and as far he was already planted, his leg was down. But again, the official made the call right there.
So a running into the kicker penalty cost the Rainbows dearly as Chaffetz missed his field goal from 35 yards. New life, and they punch it in for the touchdown. Extra point by Chaffetz is good. 21-7 the score. Rainbows over BYU with 9:55 to go in the first half on the Rainbow Football Network.
Take a look on the streets. The 1990 cars by Toyota are here, bringing a new decade of quality and style that you've come to expect from Toyota. And leading the way, the all-new Celica, with a bold, revolutionary design, unlike any car you've ever seen from Toyota. Catch a glimpse on the street, then come in and see them all up close. The 1990s are here at your Toyota Hawaii dealers now.
Wow, to think it was only a year ago. There I was, putting in 8 hours a day at that dead-end job, day in, day out, the same faces, the same low-paying, stupid work, the boss from hell. Can't believe I didn't call Hawaii Transportation Systems sooner. This is really great. They taught me to drive the big rigs, the straight trucks and tractor trailers, and I'm finally making the kind of money I deserve thanks to the training I got at Hawaii Transportation Systems. After all, they're accredited by the National Association for Trade and Technical Schools. That really gave me an edge over those other guys. And thanks to Hawaii Transportation Systems job placement assistance, I was on the road in no time. Yeah, Hawaii Transportation Systems really made it happen for me. Best move I ever made. And all it took was a phone call. I can still remember the number, 847-3221. Yeah, that's it. 847-3221. What a difference that call's made for me. Thanks to Hawaii Transportation Systems, it's going to be a great year.
9:55 to play in the first half. The Cougars are on the board, taking advantage of a penalty against James Burton for running into the kicker. Gave them new life, and BYU took advantage for the touchdown. Matt Bellini's ninth of the season. And here is Earl Kaufman to kick it off. Waiting deep is Jeff Seidner for the Rainbows. End over end, Seidner waits, takes it to 3. Right up the middle behind the wedge, the 10, the 15, angles to the left, tries to leap away at the 22, but cannot do it. And that's where the Rainbows will have it, first and 10. Josh Arnold on the stop after a 20-yard return. And right now, let's pause for station identification on the Rainbow Football Network.
Weekday mornings, it's Warren Moran with news, business, weather, sports, and traffic. Give us 30 minutes, we'll give you the world. All you need to know is on KHVH Honolulu, News Radio 99.
Once again, the Rainbows go with the no-huddle attack. And the Rainbows look a little confused out here as Chris Roscoe is late getting out with 7 seconds, 6, 5 left on the 25-second clock. Trips to the right. Gabriel calling the signal, snaps the ball, handoff up the middle. This is Lamar Young surging to the 29-yard line, a 6-yard pickup on first down. He almost broke free that time. And the Rainbows, they're almost their own worst enemy on the no-huddle attack there.
Yeah, and the last thing you want to do is use something different and have it backfire at you, too. What the Rainbows have to do is establish momentum right away. You can sense the crowd is a little more quieter. There's not that much excitement in the air. You have to get that excitement going, and you have to constantly put the pressure on this BYU team.
And a little antsy after the BYU Cougars got into the end zone. Roscoe wide left, Branch wide right, out of the double slot on second and 4 from the 29. Back to pass goes Gabriel off of play action, throws down the middle. This is complete. MacArthur at the 45-yard line. First down, Rainbows.
What Garrett,
a pickup of 16.
What Garrett does, he buys himself time with the fake. He forces the lineman to bite on the fake, and he just lets MacArthur clear the zone, and he gets right into it. Great pass. That was a good pass.
Troy Fuller on the stop, the senior from Bountiful, Utah. First and 10 Rainbows at their own 45, leading 21-7. Lamar Young in its setback for the Rainbows. Ahuna in motion from right to left. Gabriel rolls left, has plenty of time, throws on the run. Wide open, Roscoe at the 40, spins back, trying to cut down the sidelines, picks up an extra 6 yards before being driven out of bounds by Brian Mitchell. Roscoe did a down and out, caught the ball, spun away, and had to be dragged out of bounds by two Cougar defenders. Pickup of 20 on the play.
You know, they're putting single coverage on Chris Roscoe. They have Mitchell watching Roscoe all the way. Roscoe presses upfield, causes Mitchell to turn his back on him, and then makes a great cut outside.
And the Rainbows at the BYU 35. Garrett Gabriel has thrown for 220 yards in just the first half. First and 10, Bowes. Back to pass, he goes again. Shovel pass, Seidner, the 30. Flags go down as he is hit. We got two flags down, and I'm not sure what it's going to be. I think, given that Bud Orr is clapping, holding against the Rainbows.
I think they're going to call holding on Larry Jones against Bud Orr. Larry makes the key block there. He has the best block. He has to allow his defense lineman to get upfield, which he does, and then to turn him to the outside, and they're saying he grabbed his arm right there.
Well, he did have some kind of a grab. That'll march the Rainbows back 10 yards. The last shipment of 89 Toyotas has arrived, and your Toyota dealer has the best deal of the decades. Free air conditioning, plus a free vehicle protection package from Toyota. Rainbows with a 21-7 lead here in the first half. 8.5 minutes to play in the second quarter. Jeff Newman in the game at right slot back for the Rainbows on first and 20 from the 45 of BYU. Gabriel to pass, throws down the middle. Newman wide open, 10-5, touchdown. A busted coverage, and Jeff Newman scores his first touchdown as a Rainbow, a 45-yard hookup with Garrett Gabriel. Jeff Newman, number one. Recruited as a quarterback, 6 feet even, 190 pound sophomore from California. Only his second reception of the season. He was just uncovered the entire way.
Garrett was looking to his right, looking for a Branch on the outside. Then he saw Newman standing all alone on the hash. Newman was waving his hands. Garrett just puts the ball right there, and Newman just marches in the end zone.
And with that touchdown, another $300 to the University of Hawaii, the Touchdowns for Teaching program funded by AmFac, JMB Hawaii, and Liberty House, all committed to excellence in education. Jason Elam's extra point makes it 28-7 Bows on the Rainbow Football Network.
How swift is the new Suzuki Swift? Well, it's got a powerful 16-valve, 100-horsepower engine under the hood, plus standard features like a Kenwood AM-FM cassette deck, Bridgestone Potenza tires, front air dam, side skirts, rear spoiler.
Wow, that is a fast car.
It's more than fast. It's swift.
For a limited time, you can get $500 back on any 89 two-door Swift GTI with automatic transmission. Just call 839-CARE for the Suzuki dealer nearest you.
It's University of Hawaii Rainbows football season, and that means local-style tailgate picnics. This year, don't fuss with all the cooking. Let Zippy's Restaurants complement your favorite foods with its poo-poo platter. This week, take the mixed poo-poo platter of chicken katsu, mahi-mahi, teriyaki beef, Portuguese sausage, and hot dogs. Just call an hour before at any Zippy's location and pick it up on the way to the game.
Zippy's, good fun for everyone.
With a loader on the front end and a backhoe on the rear, there's a cat machine to help you shift your life into high gear.
The affordable 416 backhoe loader, Caterpillar quality and Big Cat rugged. The 416 is built from the ground up and it's built for you. Call Pacific Machinery. We're your Caterpillar dealer on Oahu, Maui, the Big Island, and Kauai.
There's a cat machine to help you shift your life into high gear.
Pacific Machinery.
Believe it or not, 28-7 Rainbows with 8:09 to play in the first half. And the Rainbows have thoroughly dominated BYU to this point. Rainbows lining up in an onside kick formation, now split out of it, as Jason Elam will boot it away from the 35-yard line into his approach, and there's the kick. It is high, it is deep, angling to the right side. It is taken at the 10-yard line by Whittingham, up to the 15, spinning away, the 20, and out to the 25-yard line. Check that. That was not Whittingham. That was Eric Mortensen on the return, and we've got a little post-play scuffle with Pat Gordon locked up with Micah Matsuzaki, who, of course, is from St. Louis and has played many games on this field. 17-yard return for Mortensen out to the 26-yard line.
If people in the stadium watch the kickoffs, that shows one glaring strength that UH has over BYU: speed. We're just running by them and running around them and attacking the guy on the 15, 20-yard line.
First and 10, Cougars at their own 26, and they trail 28-7. Bellini in motion from right to left. Whittingham, the single setback. Rainbows pressure, Decker, and they've got him in sack in. Mark Odom with the first sack of the game for the Rainbows. And Alice Ideda is the quick sack to him winner tonight. Each time the Rainbows sack BYU, Alice wins a 40-pound sack of Quickrete vinyl concrete patcher.
Alice, let me tell you how they did it, Alice. They landed 8 men on the line of scrimmage. They showed blitz all the way, and they sent everybody. They only had 3 men playing in the defensive backfield.
Odom leads the Rainbows now with 7 sacks. The junior from Long Beach doing his dance after a loss of 5 for BYU. Second and 15. Play action fake. Detmer rolls to his left. Sets up. Pump fake. At the 20, he'll run. Runs into Eliwanibi. Now goes backwards. Hit by Talley and dropped. Another sack. As Detmer that time ad-libbed. And he ad-libbed right into the hands of the Rainbows as Talley continued to pursue him along with Joaquin Barnett. And as Detmer was running around and pump faking, he ran right into his own offensive lineman, then retreated backwards, and Talley grabbed him and yanked him down. Alice, another 40 pounds of quick break for you.
Alice again, just a lot of pressure.
Herman Talley, 6'4", 225, junior from Mississippi. He is right behind Odom with 6 sacks. Now third down and 20 from the 16-yard line. BYU back to pass. Detmer, he's hit again. Odom has got him. Another sack at the 2. Back to back to back. Sack to sack to sack. The Rainbows are all over Ty Detmer. And the punting unit is on 4th and 33. 3 plays and a loss of 23 yards for the Cougars. Punting is Earl Kaufman from deep in his own end zone. Seidner and Briggs waiting, and it's a short kick that bounces and sticks at the 40-yard line, and there will be no return. Downed at the 42. and the Rainbows will have it after a 39-yard punt. 28-7 Rainbows. And I have to steal a line from Al Michaels. Do you believe in miracles?
Yes, I do. I believe.
The House of Soup has local-style plate lunches for every appetite, located downtown on Union Mall and in Mo'ili'ili on Baratania. And the Rainbows have worked up quite an appetite here in the first quarter, leading by three touchdowns. Going for more. First and 10 from their BYU 42. Ahuna in motion to the left. Gabriel rolls left, throws an out pattern. Ooh, over MacArthur, incomplete in the left flat. And that was a dangerous pass as Norman Dixon, the junior from New Orleans, a safety lurking in the area, thinking interception.
Dwayne Johnson got his hand on that ball. Good play by Dwayne Johnson, outside linebacker for BYU, getting his hands in the air and tips the ball and forces the ball to lose its trajectory.
Garrett now 14 of 16 passing for 265 yards in just the first half. Rainbows have had four possessions and have scored four touchdowns. See if they can make it five straight. Second and 10 from the Cougar 42. Trips to the left for the Rainbows. Gabriel rolls left. Farmer, a blocker in front. Throws to Roscoe, who's hit and drilled. And incomplete. Nice stick by Brian Mitchell as Roscoe ran the down and out at the 28-yard line of BYU. Had the ball gotten there just a second earlier, Roscoe might have been able to hold on.
Mitchell makes a good play stripping the ball here. Just a point of contact. But again, Chris is going to tell himself, and Chris was thinking he should have hanged on to that ball.
Roscoe with four catches for 49 yards in this game. Now third and 10 for the Rainbows. You know, we talked with Paul Johnson yesterday, and he was just so confident that we looked at him like he was crazy. He said, I think we're going to beat him. We said, how are you going to do it? He said, well, we've got to be able to run the football. And you and I looked at each other like, oh, no, not this again. And they have come out, and they've really put on a show. Busted play. Gabriel will scramble, and he will barely get back to the line of scrimmage. As it looked like they were going to run the whirly bird option.
We got a late flag.
Late flag, and it could be a late hit against BYU. Have to wait and see. Pat Sweeney, unsportsmanlike conduct.
Great.
There might have been some taunting going on after the play had finished.
Well, you see there, it looks like Bob Davis. Oh, there it is. What they did was, after they made the hit, I'll let Pat Sweeney talk first.
Well, you can barely hear him, but it's unsportsmanlike conduct. That's an automatic first down.
You can't swear on the field. And if you have a referee that doesn't want you to swear and he warns you, he'll call you. After they made the tackle on Gabriel, Bob Davis and number 9, I forgot his name, number 9,
Chad Robinson.
They're just shaking their fists over Gabriel, and that's what the call was.
First and 10 Rainbows as they get the benefit of the penalty here on the BYU 27. Option to the right. Gabriel with a seam, stumbling, leaps to the 20, still on his feet, down to the 19-yard line, written down by Troy Fuller. Boy, Garrett Gabriel, as he moved out to the right side, looked like a guy with a piano on his shoulders. He was stumbling and trying to keep his feet and did a great job of maintaining his balance to get it to the 19-yard line for a pickup of 8.
You know, we talked to Coach Johnson yesterday, and he says the key is blocking their linebackers. Either our tackles or our slots have to block the linebackers to run the option. On that play, Dan Ahuna gets off, just cleans Johnson right at the legs, and he's able to turn up the field.
Second and 2 Rainbows on the BYU 19. Farmer up the middle, leaping, stays on his feet to the 15 and down to the 14 as he was taken down by Johnson, an ankle grab. And good running inside by Farmer for the first down. Boy, Jamal, you could see he really makes a difference out on the field. 5-yard pickup, and the Rainbows on the move again. They lead 28-7 here in the first half. Looking to end 10 years of misery. And well on their way to doing it. As Nelson Befitel, our spotter, says, hopefully. First and 10 Rainbows. Gabriel rolls. Trouble pass to Seidner at the 15, the 10, still on his feet, high stepping to the 5, the 3, the 2. And down there, first and goal Rainbows as Troy Fuller saved the touchdown. Jeff Seidner coming off the field to low 5s.
there's a term in sports, and you know the term, speed kills. And that's just pure speed. He just runs through people with speed. It's just too quick once he's in the open field.
13-yard pickup, and the Rainbows are on the one-yard line of BYU. Jamal Farmer in the backfield, along with Mark Odom and Richard Stevenson out of the power eye set. Handoff up and over. Farmer, touchdown, Rainbows. Number two for Jamal on the night. And it's 34-7, Rainbows. And with that touchdown, AmFac, JMD Hawaii and Liberty House donate another $300 to the University of Hawaii. AmFac, JMB Hawaii and Liberty House, committed to excellence in education. Bob Wagner said in the pregame show, there's no reason that it has to be close, and it isn't. Extra point, Jason Elam, good. 35-7 Rainbows in the first half on the Rainbow Football Network.
Hawaii dealers are celebrating Servco's 70th year with an anniversary value package on all 1990 Corollas and Camrys. For just $70, your value package may include power steering, AM/FM stereo, power windows, aluminum wheels, and more, saving you over $800 on certain models. Offer ends November 30th and supplies are limited. So hurry to your Toyota dealers now.
I love what you do for me.
Those who want the best possible home loan, Bank of Hawaii has a fast loan to fit your budget. And our Banco Adjustable Rate Mortgage guarantees a credit decision in 3 business days, or we pay you $25 each extra business day up to $100. Our appraisal and escrow services add convenience, too. Ask your realtor or visit any branch. A fast credit decision and the home you want. It's great to be your bank. Bank of Hawaii, Hawaii's bank. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Up David Mossman leaping through the air, making the stop on the kickoff of Eric Mortensen. And again, the Rainbows, with excellent special teams coverage, pin the Cougars down at the 19-yard line as Ty Detmer drops back into the huddle and says, what was the number of that truck that was wearing green and ran over us? 35-7 Rainbows, 3:21 to play first half. Cougars with back split behind Detmer. He's back to pass. Throws short to the tight end. Complete to Smith at the 30-yard line. Stopped by Brian Addison. First down, Cougars gain of 10.
Again, Addison is a little upset at himself because they're playing man-to-man defense. The strong safety has the tight end all the way. Addison is giving Smith too much cushion to work with. He has to press that cushion and stay tight on it.
35, you know, I keep repeating it just because I'm not sure I believe it myself. Rainbows flogging BYU here in the first half. Back to pass, Detmer from the 31. Throws, complete to Franson at the 45. Slips away from Walter Briggs and gets tackled by 3 Rainbows who sandwich him at the 47-yard line. James Burton there, along with Brian Addison and Gavin Robertson. Well, you have to give the Cougars some credit for coming out composed here and trying to work their offensive attack instead of just panicking here.
There's a lot of time here. There's a whole half to play. They're going to stay with their game plan. The Rainbows have to keep the pressure coming.
16-yard pickup. Detmer back to pass. Hit as he throws. Complete at the 47 of Hawaii to Chris Smith, the tight end. He's thrown down by Addison. Smith is the leading receiver for the Cougars. 6'4", 230 pounds, a junior from Canada. Came into this game with 38 catches for 656 yards and 3 TDs. He's recruited by UCLA and USC. Actually went to Arizona first and then transferred to BYU. Pickup of 7 on the play, so it's 2nd and 3 now from the Rainbow 46. Bows lead BYU 35-7. Back to pass, Detmer has time to throw behind that huge offensive line. Fires for Franson, incomplete. Too high at the 35 of Hawaii. Coverage by Mike Colson.
The Rainbow's doing a good job of compressing the pocket. That's the thing. You want to compress the pocket against Detmer and allow guys like Odom and Talley to work the edges. What Odom and Talley's job this game is to work the edges, work hard upfield. On that play that Detmer completed the ball deep down the middle to Smith, Odom got free, but he hit Detmer low. He has to attack him high. They have to constantly hit him, put pressure on him.
Third and three from the 46 of Hawaii, BYU, and they will pass. Detmer drops over the middle, fires deep down the middle, and incomplete. A leaping attempt at the 15-yard line for Brent Nyberg, and he came up just shy of the football, and he had the Rainbows beat on that play. James Burton, the freshman from Long Beach, almost got beat big time, but Nyberg could not stretch out and get to the football. Good throw by Detmer.
And James Burton got up and said, hallelujah.
Detmer, 9 of 13 in the air for 172 yards. The punting unit on 4th and 3. And here is Kaufman, who will boom it away. Seidner will field it at the Rainbow 9. Up the middle he goes, and oh, he is drilled. And a flag comes down. Could be a face mask penalty. Looking at the way Seidner went down, it appeared as though his neck was going a different direction than the rest of his body. Tackled by Mark Neal. Now it's a clip against the Rainbows. So that will push them back inside the 10-yard line. 37-yard punt, 5-yard return.
Clipping during the run back by the receiving team at the distance of the goal line, first down.
So the Rainbows will have to be careful here. 1:40 to play in the first half. They have a huge lead of 35-7, but they are on their own 7-yard line, and you'd have to think they would do something conservative here.
Or they might do what we don't expect, the deep ball to Roscoe on the first play.
Throw the bomb. We've seen it all tonight.
Well, Roscoe's not in. Leonard Lau, Branch.
Branch wide right. Lau to the left. Out of the double slot. Handoff up the middle. This is Farmer plowing his way to the 11-yard line.
That's why Coach Johnson is in that booth, and I'm in this booth here.
Well, your forte is stocks and bonds.
Well, where the market's acting nowadays, well, I don't want to put a plug for Shir Salim and Hutton where I work.
And, then don't.
Mike Dorsey and me and partners, but I won't say that.
Clock continues to run. 117, 116, 115, a 4-yard pickup by Farmer. Rainbows will be very happy to run out the clock and go into the locker room with a 4-touchdown lead. The Rainbows have had 5 possessions in the first half, and all 5 have been converted into TDs. Second and 6. Gabriel to pass, rolls left, looking deep, throwing the bomb for Roscoe, left sideline, leaps and has got it at the 50. Knocked out of bounds by Brian Mitchell. Should get into coaching.
I should, see? And Don Robb just gave me a bill for my plug. $150. Oh, my goodness.
39-yard hookup for Chris Roscoe and Garrett Gabriel. Gabriel's got to be over 300 yards passing for just the first half.
Peter, I forgot my wallet. Peter Iguchi, bring a check. We've got to pay Don Robb's $150.
Gabriel with 317 yards passing. 45 seconds to play first half. Gabriel rolls right, looking to the sideline, throws it away as Derek Branch was running it down and out at the 30-yard line, and he one-hopped it to Branch at the 40. So that stops the clock with 39 seconds left, and the Rainbows with a 2nd and 10 from the 50-yard line.
What the Rainbows can play for is they need about 20 to 25 yards more. Even with the way Jason's kicking, maybe 15 yards more and bring Jason in, or do they play for the touchdown? Again, they're going to play according to what BYU gives them.
Rainbows have 2 timeouts left, so they can conceivably run the ball if they want to. Double slot formation. Roscoe left, Branch to the right. Back to pass, Gabriel has a heavy rush. Screen right side to Farmer, and it's thrown away. They were trying to work the same play that resulted in a Farmer 83-yard touchdown gallop. The screen to the right side, and that time it really didn't work too well because there was too much penetration right at the start of the play by Tim Adams, the nose tackle, and Bud Orr. They got up the field in the hurry, and so Garrett really made the wise decision in not forcing.
Not force anything.
33 seconds left in the first half, and it'll be 3rd and 10 from the 50-yard line. Roscoe to the left, Branch to the right. Slot backs are MacArthur and Ahuna, Jamal Farmer, the tailback behind Gabriel. Gabriel takes the snap, drops back, looks over the middle, throws incomplete on the left side for Ahuna. And that stops the clock with 28 seconds left, and it's 4th down. 4th and 10. Well, this is an interesting decision here. You punt the ball away. That's the safe decision. Kyle Alu will come out for his first punt of the night. Has not had any blocked this season. He averages 42 yards a kick, and the Rainbows just want to get this ball away safely. Takes the snap. Sky-high punt. Beautiful kick. Mitchell will not even attempt to field it. Lets it bounce at the 20 to the 15. Takes a Rainbow bounce to the 10, inside the 10 to the 6-yard line. And the Cougars will have it there with 13 seconds left. And the Rainbows with a 35-7 lead at the half. I tell you, this is beyond belief.
Well, for Portuguese, I'm speechless. What can I say? It's the Rainbows are playing with emotion, but what they're doing is what we talked about. They're doing something different. They're running the snake. They're putting a lot of pressure on defense, which we thought they were going to do, but they're making sacks. They're getting Detmer down on the ground, but they're not letting up. They're continuing putting that pressure.
1st and 10, Detmer will run a handoff to Bellini, hit by Joaquin Barnett for a loss of 2 on the play, but the Cougars will run out the clock, and that'll do it for the first half. 35-7, Rainbows, listen to these fans. They have waited a long time to be able to do this, but there is still another 30 minutes of football to be played, and you know that's what the Rainbow coaches are going to tell their players.
I tell you right now what's happening. Leo Goas, Larry Jones, Walter Briggs, the seniors, Dana Director, as they run into the locker room, they're stopping right in the middle of that locker room. They say, gang, they're grabbing guys by the throat and say, don't you dare let up. We got to keep on going. We got to score another 35 points next half, and we can't let them score any. And they're throwing fits right now in the locker room. They're not celebrating. They're throwing fits at one another and putting the pressure on one another to keep the momentum going. And Coach Wagner is going to be able to just sit back and watch this take place.
Well, it should be a happy locker room. 35-7, the Rainbows lead. You know, Paul Johnson gave us that old story about we've got to run the football. You and I looked at him yesterday and we're just thinking to ourselves, if you try to run the football, it's going to be a long night. And he did not give us any indication that he was going to pull out all the stops.
Not at all. In fact, I went home and said, Lord, please,
don't run the football.
Let him throw the ball. Anything, but let him throw the ball.
But now what's happening, the running game is open. They've opened the running lanes with the passing game. BYU is totally confused. So now running lanes are starting to open. Look for them to have a good mixture of run and pass in the second half.
Before we break away, I'm going to bring Don Robbs in. We had dinner the other night, courtesy of Larry Goas,
yes,
and
yes.
Nicholas, and maybe Paul Johnson was sitting at the next table and we didn't notice him, but we discussed the game plan, and it's happening right before our eyes.
Well, I remember the question.
Don Robbs, you're a prophet.
Well, no, it was my feeling that unless they did something so dramatically different, that BYU would be befuddled that they didn't have much of a chance. And they did exactly what the three of us discussed. It's like we sat down and wrote the game plan for them.
Well, for once, they listened to us, and they're up 35-7.
Nice job, guys.
It's all yours.
Okay, halftime, 35-7. Rainbows in front of BYU. Let me say that again. Halftime, 35-7. Rainbows lead, and we'll be back at Aloha Stadium in just a moment.
Where can you go and enjoy a really good plate lunch? One with home-style goodness and the food bursting with flavor. Well, the House of Soup has a wide variety of plate lunches like chicken katsu, breaded mahi-mahi, spicy curry stew, and teriyaki pork steak, just to mention a few. The House of Soup on Union Mall in downtown or on Meritage, Pennsylvania at the Old Graces location. The House of Soup, serving great local-style plate lunches.
Do it. There's nothing to it. You can do it with Quick
you can do it with Quikrete. Quikrete Final Concrete Patcher is the game winner for those around-the-home projects. Available in 40-pound bags, plus easy-to-use 7-pound pails. Quikrete, your winning answer for cracked sidewalks, driveways, lanais, entranceways, and more.
You can do it. There's nothing to it. You can do it with Quikrete.
If you're ready to move up to laser printing, visit Inacomp for a Hewlett-Packard LaserJet printer. It's easy to improve your image with an HP LaserJet Series 2 or 2D printer. It delivers crisp, high-resolution output, so everything from letters to business reports looks sharper and more professional. For the Hewlett-Packard LaserJet printer that's right for your office needs and the service and support that only an authorized HP dealer can provide, come to Inacomp today. Inacomp Computer Center, 250 Ward Avenue.
It's a joyous halftime at Aloha Stadium tonight. The Rainbows leading BYU 35-7. And here to make some sense of the numbers, Chuck Alder.
Well, Hawaii has doubled the first downs that BYU has. They have 18, BYU has 9. Hawaii has attempted 22 passes, completed 16 for 317 yards. BYU has attempted 13, completed 9 for 172 yards. Hawaii has rushed for 90 yards. They have a total of 407 yards for the first half. BYU has been held to 1 yard on the ground. They have 173 yards for the first half. Four penalties assessed against Hawaii for 37 yards, two against BYU for 20. There was one punt by Hawaii, and that was for 44 yards, and three by BYU for averaging 41 yards per punt. That's the way the scoring went in the first half with 11:21 to go. Farmer scored on a one-yard run. They converted with 7-0. 2:34 to go in the first quarter. Gabriel Tarasco for 8 yards. They converted. It was 14-0. And with 14 minutes to go and a half, Gabriel DeFarmer, 83 yards. They converted. It was 21-0. Then BYU scored. Bellini on a 1 yard run. They converted. It was 21-7. With 8:09 and a half, Gabriel to Newman, 45 yard pass. They converted. It was 28-7. And with 3:27 to go and a half, Farmer on a 1 yard run. And Hawaii converted again. The halftime score, Hawaii 35 and BYU 7.
Chuck, we're going to let you go sharpen your pencils and hope you get to use them as much in the second half.
That would be great.
Thank you. Chuck Alder, 35-7 Rainbows. Pearl City marching band here at halftime, one of the most spectacular high school bands in the nation, is down there at halftime. And also on the sidelines, I understand, it with Brooks Baer, is the young man who quarterbacked the last Rainbow victory over BYU. Is that right, Brooks?
You got it, Don. Sitting down here with Alex Kaloy, it's a real pleasure to sit down here and watch this game with them. This game means a lot to you. You're the last quarterback to beat BYU, and you've told me down here you're just about sick and tired, Alex, of hearing people say, this is Alex Kaloy, he's the last quarterback to beat BYU.
Yeah, it's been pretty close to 15 years now, and it's really nice to see the Hawaii play so well. I think not only for the team, but for the state, for the fans. We've been supporting this team so long, and we're kind of sick and tired of losing to them. Now, the game's not over, but it looks pretty good.
Looks good, 35-7 at halftime. Of course, we don't want to count our chickens before they hatch, but give me your impressions of the first half.
They're just playing terrific. You give a lot of credit to the coaches getting the team this well prepared. They just look ready to play. BYU has just been caught off guard, and we're just sticking it to them. And you can see it on the sideline with the players. They're just jumping all over each other, and they're excited, and the fans over here are going crazy.
Let's talk about Garrett Gabriel. You're an old quarterback. Garrett's the guy that's in there tonight trying to do the job. He admittedly had a really bad week last week. He is coming out. You look at his eyes on the sidelines. Tremendous confidence, tremendous leadership. The guys are lining up right behind him. And I don't have the figures on Garrett, but he is having a career night tonight.
Well, he's having a great game. You know, one thing people don't understand, playing good every week is hard to do. And Garrett had a tough week last week, but he looks really good tonight. He's making a lot of good decisions. He's just playing real well. He's leading the team all the way up and down the field. And I don't think there's any question now, what quarterback we're going to play. It's it's going to be Garrett. He's just playing that well.
You think he's been too much maligned, too much criticism about Garrett's performances in the past? He's been the number one guy. The coaches have stuck with him, but he does get a lot of criticism.
Well, the team don't play well, and the first thing people do is say, oh, the quarterback screwed up. Well, again, this whole offense is based around the quarterback, and if he doesn't have a good game, then the team's not going to have a good game. And he's just having a phenomenal game, and you can see it on the score, 35-7. I mean, who would ever think first half, 35-7?
Tell me what it's like. It was 1974 in the old Termite Palace when you last beat BYU, when the state last beat BYU in what is the annual big game. Tell me about that game.
Well, that game back then probably didn't mean as much as it does now, but the game was won with five field goals by a field goal kicker by the name of Reinhold Stuprich, and we won 15-13. Kind of ironic, they had, with about 30 seconds left in the game, they missed a field goal shot from about 20 yards to beat us. So that was just, back then it just wasn't as big a game. It just, at that time, as the years went on, we kept losing and losing and losing. You think, oh boy, that was a big one.
And that was your first game as a starter.
That was the first game. Coach Price, Larry Price, he gave me to start that game, and we got lucky and got the win.
You don't always come down to the sidelines. You say it's been a long time.
I have never been on this field for 13 years. I talked with Coach Adrillin a couple days ago, and he said, why don't you come down and see the game? And I'm sure glad I'm here.
I watch you on some of the plays, and it's hard to use this expression because you're standing up down here, but you are, so to speak, on the edge of your chair. You got your fist clenched, and you're really into it.
Well, I guess once you've played it, it stays with you. I can see what's going on, and I can see what kind of decisions Garrett's making. He's just making some good ones, and when you're on the field, you can see it a lot closer, and I'm a little excited now, I must say.
Okay, I'm gonna ask Don Robbs if he has a question for you, because we've got him plugged in here, Don.
Alex, I can't say that I remember that specific game back in 1974, but I certainly remember you. In fact, I tried to talk you into becoming a broadcaster a couple of years ago, but the fans may want to know where some of those other rainbows were from that team. I remember the Colloy to Wagner hookup, for example. Where's Rick Wagner?
Rick is in California. I'm not sure what city he's in, but he's working with a law firm, doing quite well. We had a good team that year, and we had a great coach, and God, thinking that far back is kind of difficult to do. That makes me feel a little old. I'm only 34 now. I want you to remember that.
Okay.
I can't believe you can't remember that game.
Oh, I remember. I don't remember the specifics. I remember Reinhold Stuprich's
yes.
toe.
Yeah. Well, he at that time, I think he kicked a record at that game, too. I think he kicked a 50-yard field goal that game, and that made it 15-13.
Alex, thanks for sharing some memories with us tonight.
Sure, my pleasure.
And let's hope that after tonight they can say, hey, aren't you Garrett Gabriel, the guy, a quarterback, the last rainbow win?
That would make it easier for me,
I bet it would. Thank you.
Thank you.
Alex Colloy on the sidelines with Brooks Baer. Rainbows lead 35-7 at the half, and we'll be right back.
Take a look on the streets. The 1990 cars by Toyota are here, bringing a new decade of quality and style that you've come to expect from Toyota. And leading the way, the all-new Celica, with a bold, revolutionary design, unlike any car you've ever seen from Toyota. Catch a glimpse on the street, then come in and see them all up close. The 1990s are here at your Toyota Hawaii dealers now.
No matter what happens to the rainbows, your season will be picture perfect with a great lineup from Kodak and Long's Drugs. Get 12 bonus exposures when you buy a multi-pack of 35mm 100-speed Kodacolor Gold Film. And with a 75-cent instant redeemable coupon, the savings converge for extra points. Check out Long's ad in tomorrow's paper for more particulars. Kodacolor Gold multi-packs available at your nearby Long's Drugs on Oahu.
You'll always find the very best at Long's.
From NFL and collegiate action to the OIA, Oceanic Cable is your football headquarters. Get into the excitement of high school football from Aloha Stadium every week on Cable 17. And be sure to support Oahu's public schools by attending OIA events. Remember, school spirit promotes personal pride in our young people.
Catch the OIA quarterfinal football playoffs on Oceanic Cable, Channel 17, November 2nd and 3rd, live from Aloha Stadium.
Oh,
halftime. Entertainment provided by the Pearl City Chargers Marching Band. An outstanding aggregation. And about 500 strong as you look out there. And they have thousands of balloons making a triple red, white, and blue arch across the way. Just to bring you up to date on the News Radio 99 tailgate poll brought to you by the 19 Subway sandwich and salad stores on Oahu, Subway your way. The question this week was, should college athletes be paid to perform? And your response would seem to indicate very overwhelming numbers on the no side. In fact, 92% say no, college athletes should not be paid to perform, and only 8% feel they should. Now, that number is still open if you'd like to call through the game and cast your vote. 942-5222, and then enter code 0990. That's 942-5222, entry code 0990 to cast your ballot in the tailgate poll brought to you by Subway and by the Talking Phonebook Island Directory of Oahu. Halftime about to conclude. We're hoping that Rick Blangiardi will be able to come over here, but as I look over on the TV side here tonight, they have apparently elected to stay live through the halftime. Rick, of course, is wrapping up his broadcast career tonight here at Aloha Stadium on the television side, having accepted a job with King Television in Seattle. In fact, he has already made the relocation, and he, like Larry Beal, stipulated that he wanted to be here for this game tonight. Do you suppose if Blange and Larry Beal knew something the rest of us did not? Are you listening, Bill Kwan? At any rate, If Blanche can't make it over at halftime, why, we hope we can get him to drop in the booth after the ball game and chat with us for a moment. We'll be back at Aloha Stadium. It's halftime. Rainbows leading BYU 35-7.
Only one airline offers business class service on every flight leaving Honolulu. It also flies frequent schedules to Los Angeles, San Francisco, Denver, and provides convenient connections to over 100 mainland cities. For 20 years, this airline has provided warm and caring service to Hawaii's travelers. Airline, Continental. And Hawaii is going places on Continental Airlines.
The 80s aren't over yet, and neither are the good deals your Toyota dealers have to offer on used cars. They're moving out a new fleet of 1988 used Toyotas at low, low prices. Over 200 Corolla sedans and Tercel coupes and five-door hatchbacks are now available. But the supply is limited, so you've got to move fast. Hurry to your nearest Toyota dealer now for one of the last great deals of the 80s.
I'll tell you, the fans here tonight have been treated to a halftime show that probably belongs at the Super Bowl. Pearl City High School and a spectacular performance that had the fans giving these youngsters a standing ovation. And not only that, but the BYU broadcasters in the booth next to us stood and they gave applause to the Pearl City Band. It was chicken skin time here tonight as they brought out the flags and the balloons and this 400, 500 strong band. We should all be very proud of the Pearl City High School Chargers marching band and everybody else that goes with that band. The flags, the ROTC team that was on the field. It was truly an outstanding halftime show. 35-7, Rainbows lead with about 4.5 minutes to go before play will resume. Late scores in tonight. Florida State beat number 2 Miami today, in case you hadn't heard, 24-10. There go the balloons. Arkansas over Houston, 45-39. And Southern Cal shut out Stanford, 19-0. We do not have a score on San Diego State, UTEP. That's the only incomplete WAC game. Earlier today, Colorado State rolled over Utah, 50-10. Tony Elford set a WAC, rushing 310 yards rushing today, had 3 touchdowns. The other game found Wyoming edging New Mexico by a score of 24-23. The Miami loss, really the big upset of the day. Notre Dame beat Pitt today 45-7. The Irish have won 20 in a row. And on the scoreboard, oh, the balloons. They broke. Now they're letting them go. They tried to release the balloons And apparently the string broke and they wouldn't get out of here. Now they're going up. Colorado beat Oklahoma, Nebraska over Iowa State, and that sets up a big game next weekend in the Big Eight, Colorado and the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Number 5, Michigan won. Number 6, Alabama beat Penn State when they blocked a field goal by the Nittany Lion with time running out. And that's about it. You can get the rest of the scores on News Radio 99 after our broadcast tonight. We're just about set to go with the second half here at Aloha Stadium. We'll be back with Larry Beal, Larry Goas, and the rest of the gang in just a moment.
Hey, football fans. Ted's Calby Drive-In has tailgate specials just for you. Yobo-style box lunches with chicken, barbecue meat, rice, mandu, and kimchi. Ted's also has specials on marinated Calby and barbecue chicken to cook on your hibachi at your tailgate happening. And side orders of salad, mandu, and kimchi by pints or quarts. Ted's Calby Drive-In, minutes away from Aloha Stadium in Mapunapuna or Mueliili. It's Ted's for tailgating. Ted's Calby Drive-In.
In the screen.
At Aloha Stadium. We're just about set to go with the second half. We do have a score. San Diego State beat UTEP 34-31 tonight. So that means the only score we don't have, Larry and Larry, is how number 6 Division II St. Cloud State did tonight. They were playing North Dakota. And I know everybody was waiting for that one. So we'll have to find out tomorrow how the Huskies did tonight. All right, 1:19 to go before kickoff in the second half. Here they are again. And I say this with a certain amount of emotion when I say for the final time we introduce Larry Beal and Larry Goas.
Thank you, Don. It's unbelievable tonight. I mean, who would think 35-7 Rainbows at the half, but as you mentioned, they've got to keep it going. Got to recap the scoring here real quick. In the first quarter, Jamal Farmer, 1-yard touchdown leap, capping an 80-play, no-huddle drive by the Rainbows. Their opening possession, 7-0. Gabriel Tarasco, an 8-yard out pattern, 14-0 Rainbows after one quarter. Gabriel DeFarmer, an 83-yard screen pass, made it 21-0. After a questionable running into the kicker penalty, BYU takes it in. Bellini, a 1-yard run, made it 21-7 Rainbows. Rainbows answered with Gabriel to Jeff Newman, a 45-yard TD that made it 28-7 Rainbows. Farmer over the top from the one late in the second quarter, 35-7. Rainbows, that's where we stand coming up to the start of the third quarter. You know, we had this big celebration at halftime, helium balloons draped over the stadium. The balloons broke and they are stuck in the net behind the north end zone. And I know there's got to be people in section double V and W that are saying, somebody get those balloons down, we can't see what's going on.
And if you hear gunshots from those sections, that's people shooting at those balloons.
Jason Elam will kick off for the Rainbows to start the second half. They lead by 4 touchdowns. His approach. There's the kick. It is short, end over end, taken at the 12-yard line, up to the 15, the 20, and out to the 30-yard line. Derwin Gray, a reserve defensive back, returning the ball out to the 30-yard line, and that's where the Cougars will have it, first and 10. Joe Sardo on the stop after a 19-yard return.
This is an important drive for Rainbows. Coach Ellison is going to, they know they're going to be on defense first. The gang must set the tempo. We must set the tempo of the game on this first series. And it's very important.
Ty Detmer, 9 of 13, passing for 161 yards in the first half. Will throw on first down. Short to Bellini in the right flat. Completed the 35 to the 40. Up to the 45 as Joaquin Barnett and Mike Colson make the stop.
Again, Rainbows rushing 5 people, but not able to get home. They have to put pressure on Detmer.
15-yard pickup for BYU, and they have the ability with their passing attack to chip away, chip away, chip away. And, you know, although there are so many emotions with a 35-7 lead and you get all happy, the Cougars are one of the few teams that could turn that around.
Yes.
Rainbows have to be wary. First and 10 from the 45 of BYU. Detmer to pass again. Short throws over the middle. Whittingham wide open. 50, the 40, down the right sideline, the 30. Briggs has got him at the 20, ridden out of bounds at the 15-yard line. Just as we spoke a moment ago, the short passing game can eat up yardage in a hurry, get the backs isolated with a linebacker, and let them try to get in a foot race. And that was a huge pickup. And we saw this on the films that we watched yesterday.
What BYU does there, it's a delayed release by Whittingham. He waits till the blitz comes. He waits till everybody comes upfield. Then he clears right behind him. And there's nobody around him.
40-yard pickup for Whittingham. First and 10 Cougars at the Rainbow 14-yard line. Bellini in motion from right to left. Detmer takes the pass, takes the snap. He eludes one man. Throws into the end zone for Bellini. Incomplete. Guarded by Briggs. Good pressure on the play by Mark Odom and Augie Apelu.
Detmer does a good job getting away from Odom. Odom gets upfield in a hurry. Detmer has the presence of mind just to take a little shuffle step to the side and just buys him enough time to get the ball off.
35-7 Rainbows as we start the third quarter. For the Cougars, this is real important. Confidence-wise, it would give them a big boost to take the ball, boom, 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 go right into the end zone.
They want to put the ball in the end zone right now.
Bellini and Whittingham in the backfield. Rainbows shift along the defensive front. Come with a blitz. Detmer back to pass. Angles over to the right. Hit by Odom. Sacked back at the 30-yard line.
What's good about that play, Larry? Odom comes from his right side and runs through Big Mo. He just runs right over Big Mo and makes a sure tackle.
And Big Mo is Mo Eluwanibi, 6'5", 290, the senior from Canada. And another sack means Alice Ideda has another 40 pounds of quick freeze. The Rainbows with their fourth sack of the game. Now it's third and 25 for BYU as the Rainbows respond with some big D. Single setback is Whittingham. Detmer back to pass. Has time. Now throws deep into the end zone, and it is intercepted by Briggs. Touchback. Walter Briggs with his sixth interception of the season, intended for Brett Nyberg, and Briggs read it all the way.
Briggs lines up in his deep safety position, just reads the ball all the way. Rainbow's only rushing four people that time and able to put pressure. Briggs is sitting back there like a center fielder, reads Detmer's eyes, sees the ball release, and just times it perfectly. Big play by Walter Briggs.
And as I said, he leads the Rainbows with six INTs. Second turnover of the game for the Cougars, and that was critical for the Rainbows, who again come out with their no-huddle attack here. First and 10 from their own 20-yard line. Triple wide receiver to the left for the Rainbows. Gabriel, the quarterback, handoff to Farmer up the middle, tries to bounce away, but he's taken down on the play by Shad Hansen, the freshman from California. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage. Rainbow football is brought to you by Continental Airlines, the only airline in Hawaii with service to Paris, London, Bali, Japan, Mexico, the South Pacific, and over 100 mainland cities. Second and 10 Rainbows from their 20. Option, no, it's a handoff. Farmer running off left tackle and plowing his way for three. Tim Adams in tow.
I don't think Coach Johnson's going to play conservative, although he's run the ball twice in a row. What he's trying to do, he's just trying to right now go back into his game plan and see if BYU has made any adjustments before he does anything different, and then he's able to give Garrett a call that he knows will work.
Third and six for the Rainbows, who have a 35-7 lead here in the third quarter. Walter Briggs with his interception fought off a BYU drive. They had the opening possession of this period. Third and six for the Rainbows from the 24. Gabriel checking the play at the line of scrimmage. And he takes the snap, drops back, sets up, looking deep, over the middle for Roscoe, who has a step, and incomplete at the
40. They go to interference.
Pass interference on Brian Mitchell. Roscoe had two steps on Mitchell and was trying to come back for the football. Mitchell did not know where the ball was, and there was contact as Roscoe tried to come back for the football.
Roscoe has him beat, stopped for the ball, and Mitchell's not, see, why the ref called that play? Mitchell is not playing the ball. He's playing the man all the way. He's playing Roscoe all the way.
That is a 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
They call it
pass interference on the defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
What the official's going to call Mitchell on is what we call face guarding. He's beat, and he's just playing the man, and he's trying to grab the man and not playing the ball at all.
Mitchell upset with the call, but it was a good one, and he did not have any idea of where the football was. First and 10 Rainbows at their own 39-yard line, moving left to right here in the second half. Triple wide receiver to the right. Gabriel on the option down the line. Pitches to MacArthur, trying to turn the corner. Cougars string it out. He reverses his field at the 39, cuts it up to the 41. Good running by Dane MacArthur, stopped on the play by Dwayne Johnson with a pursuit. Good job by the Cougars there to string that play out.
They do a good job just trying to run that ball.
We've got an injured Rainbow, Sean Olivato, number 72, the center, who came into this game with a bad ankle. 6 foot, 242-pound sophomore out of Honolulu, played his high school ball at Roosevelt. Kalani Kalele'iku, who started the game because of Olivato's injury, will come in. 11:49 to go, third quarter. Rainbows with a 35-7 lead as Olivato is up and walking off the field with a limp, walking off under his own power.
Rainbows put Richard Stevenson in. I think what Coach Johnson sees is an alley, a running alley that he'll like to take advantage of a guy like Stevenson, who's a strong, straight-ahead runner.
With 317 yards passing in the first half, Garrett Gabriel has set a school record. 215 yards passing in the second quarter is another record. Second and 7 from the 42. Gabriel rolling left, has blockers in front, throwing deep down the field for Roscoe, comes back for the ball, complete at the 21-yard line, and again he beat Mitchell. Mitchell is turned around, he's like a spinning top out there, and has no clue where the football is.
Larry, last year, Mitchell was the same guy watching Roscoe. Coach Johnson didn't throw the ball to Roscoe to the fourth quarter. This year, we're throwing him to Roscoe early. He has Mitchell beat. Mitchell has a tough assignment. His job is to stay with Chris Roscoe. And Chris is turning him around. Chris is pressing him upfield. He cuts out. And Mitchell is just being really frustrated right now.